Tinkale University. How is the Josh? I hope it's very high in these tough times. Firstly, I feel privileged to be given the opportunity to address you all in this forum. Special thanks to Mr. Prasad for connecting to me, reaching out to me, and pursuing me for this video. My name is Group Captain V. Nagender Rao. I am a commissioned officer in the Indian Air Force. My specialization is in MiG-21 Russian fighter fleet. I completed 26 years of glorious service to this country, and I feel proud of it. I've been an alumni of Keel College of Engineering. I'm from the batch 1990 to 1994. I've done my BTech in Electronic and Communication Engineering from this college during that period. Last year, I visited the college campus for the Silver Jubilee celebration. I felt very proud and motivated in seeing the college come up in leaps and bounds. The very fact of the college being nominated among the top 50 NRF college is something which I am very proud of, and I congratulate each and every one of you, including the college committee, for making it to happen. Keep it up and let the Keel University flag touch the sky with glory. Let me tell you a little bit about the flashback, about the memorable days in my college during this period. In the mid of 1990, when the whole country was burning due to Mandal Commission, and when the economy was at its lowest, it was during this period the batch of 1990 students joined the college with lots of hopes and dreams. I stayed in hostel. Though in those days we did not have the good facilities which you all are having now, but to take out some positivity out of it, we learned the art of survival, and we made some die-hard friends, long-lasting friends, which we are in touch till now. All my batchmates are doing a wonderful job. Most of them are abroad, and they're all around the world, and we are really proud of what they are doing. Most of us are also connected through various media. My journey in Air Force started somewhere at end of 1993 or starting of January 1994, when I saw a newspaper article on Indian Air Force. As usual, I just cut it, filled up the form and posted and forgot about it. At the same time, I was preparing rigorously for GRE TOEFL. In those days, we have been to Bangalore to write this GRE TOEFL exam, and I applied for many of the US university for admission and received I-20 in some of the college for my masters. During the period, somewhere in first week of May 1994, I hope, when we were just completing our exams, that is the time I got a call letter from Service Selection Board, Varanasi, calling me for the Air Force entrance test. My journey started by boarding a train at Hyderabad to Varanasi. I didn't know that day. I got into the train, got down, again got into it and got down. I was on waiting list, and I didn't know, and finally something struck me and I said, let's do it. The journey started and it went on and on and on, and still the journey is on. My initial days in Air Force, I somehow felt this is not the right place. I thought I would like to join my other batchmates who have gone to US and other places all around the world and doing a wonderful job. But now, having completed 25 years of service, I feel proud of my decision and I am very happy that I continue to stay in service, and I had so many memorable days and I had so much of adventurous days. The life was full of risks, the life was full of sacrifice, and I think I had the best of my professional life and personal life. My journey in Air Force started at Bangalore at Air Force Technical College, and from there my first posting was at Bathinda. That is one of the memorable days which I had in the squadron, in the MiG-21 squadron. During this period, I also had the opportunity, and I was very lucky among my batchmates, to take active part in Kargil operations. I was at one of the forward base, and lots of memorable days which I had during that phase of Kargil. I would definitely come to the college and share with you all among the walls of KL University, because it will not be, the time will not be adequate for you to tell me about all my experiences. During the same period, for all my contribution and for whatever I did, I was awarded the President Award mentioned in dispatch in Kargil operations. After my stay in Bathinda, I went on to all around the places in the country, right from Nalia, that is in Kutch, to Northeast Calcutta, to South Hyderabad, and the northernmost place, that has been Srinagar, which has been active in the news for the last 2 decades. Life has been fully adventurous, and I had lots of memories and lots of stories to carry forward and tell you. Presently, because of the code of conduct which I need to follow, I will not be able to tell you and share all these experiences, but definitely one day I will come meet you all and share with you all. Okay everyone, I am a little busy nowadays because of the situation which you are watching in the news. But in spite of that, I know you all have lots of questions. I know most of you all have lots of queries on how to join Air Force, how is Air Force life, and what are the opportunities here, what is the pay scale, and what are the assignments and missions which you have come across. I will address all this to you all when I come to the college or in a similar platform next time when I get free. In the meantime, do visit careerindianairforce.nic.in. You got all the details on how to join the Air Force, and whatever queries are there are clearly addressed there. Till then, I would like to wish you all the very best, and for students especially, I would like to give you all a piece of advice. Live your passion and chase your passion. And there is one mantra in life which I followed, which I would like to share with you all. Early to bed, early to rise, and work like hell. Okay, thanks a lot. Thanks a lot again, once again, for giving me this opportunity to speak to you all. And stay safe. Take precautions during the COVID time. Study well. And all the best from me.
Hi all, greetings of the day. Welcome to this alumni ceremony of KLU. And it's a great honor to be with you online And you know, because of Corona, so we had to talk on a video and then come in front of you. Otherwise, I would have come in person and then talked to you guys. So, and indeed, it's a great pleasure, and I'm very happy to be with all of you. So, all the alumni are there online. And I am Pulla Reddy. I am 85-89 computer science batch. And it's been more than 30 years that I passed out of college. And it's, you know, when we are there, it was KLC, Koner Lakshmiya College of Engineering, and today it is KLU, Koner Lakshmiya University. And I'm really great to hear that it has become a college to a university. And when I visited last time, 5 years back, I was astonished to see the entire campus. It was totally changed after 25 years when I visited the college. It was totally changed, and it was a great facility the management has created here. Because when we were studying, it was like Buckingham Canal, and we used to enjoy the Buckingham Canal and the green pastures of Koner Lakshmiya Engineering College. So I'm happy for that. And you know, I'm after passing out from the college, so I was working in New Delhi for 5 years. Then I moved back to Hyderabad and I started a company called SP Software Private Limited. It's a software company where we provide all IT solutions to most of the MNC companies, multinational companies. And when I started, it was a one-man company. I was a one person. And today we have around 600, more than 600 people working in the company in Hyderabad. So it's, I feel great privilege to tell you this. And then, because the foundation is from this college, and we, when I passed out the college, so you all know, when you pass out from the college, you don't know what to do, because you enjoyed 4 years, and then once suddenly you're out of college and you want to look for a career, and which way to go also you don't know. And so it's like, okay, when I came out of college, and then we were also searching for jobs, then we got a job, and then we got some experience. Then my ultimate motto was to become an entrepreneur, and I have become an entrepreneur. And today I am a successful entrepreneur, I can say that. And then, the present, I think I'm sure a lot of people, the present batch, current batch students also will be watching this video. Sorry. So, you all are fortunate to be associated with the college, or because KLU transformed into a great facility, because you have all the state-of-the-art facilities the college is providing to you, and you should also utilize all the facilities to grow into the person you want to be and build a great future ahead. You know, when I was in college, we didn't have Wi-Fi or internet or your mobile phones or smartphones or any of the gadgets which today you all enjoying, like iPads, lots of gadgets are there in the market. And today all the gadgets are available at your fingertips. And the whole world is at your fingertip today. So you have to utilize all these things and then grow in life. And it's like the college people called me, they asked me to address the people and give them some kind of motivational points, which I felt, because when you want to become an entrepreneur, see, first thing is dedication and honesty is very, very important. whenever you commit something, you should honor it. That is the most important thing in life. Because this is not only for the entrepreneurship, it's you have to make a point that it's built in into your character. And when you come out of college, attitude is very, very important, because with attitude you can change your entire career. And then see, for the outgoing batch, I want to tell, because when you're coming out, you should take right advice from the right people. I'm sure you all would be having some connections with some technical people or the entrepreneurs, a lot of people. So you should actually go to them, tell them what you want to become in life, seek their advice. Then you get into that path. Initially, you have to struggle hard. And I'm sure because first 3-4 years, don't look at your money, because today's world is all about money. Everybody wants to become rich overnight, which is not possible. So you should always look for build great career. So that first 2-3 years, you should build your career with honesty, dedication and all, and whatever is your interest, you should try and build your career in that. That is the most important thing, because I want to tell you, whatever area you want to choose, because today here all brand students are there, like from civil to mechanical, computer science, electrical, electronics, all the branch people are here. So whichever area you are interested in, you want to build your career, better you focus in that area. Even if you fail, doesn't matter. But see, failure is stepping stones for success. You all know that. So you always focus on that particular area, and I'm sure you'll be successful in your path. So with this, I want to wish all of you a great future ahead. And then lastly, I want to tell you, if you want to take advice from me, or if you need any guidance from me, where your college has my email address, so please take my email address and write to me. I am more than happy to guide you or to advise you whatever way you wanted, whichever career you want to build. So it's my commitment to you, and I'm very thankful to the management for organizing this kind of events. Even in this pandemic situations, difficult situations, because at least we are seeing online, we are seeing each other online and then trying and interacting with each other. So let's build a great career ahead. You all have great future. And here I'm sure a lot of my colleagues also are there in this call, in online this thing. And they all, because we left college almost 31 years ago, so today in this 31 years, a lot of people must have built their own businesses and then their own, I think I'm sure a lot of people would have reached the top management positions. So you please talk to somebody. I'm sure whichever area you want to grow, there are people across, because all KLU alumni is a big group. So you can just shoot an email and then you will get the reply from any of our alumni people. So I wish all of you a great success and good luck. Thank you very much for the management for giving me this opportunity. Thank you very much.
Hi dear students, this is Tarun Kakani and I'm a student of KLCE from 2001 to 2005, and I was a student of ECE department, and I'm very glad to be sharing my experiences with you today. First of all, I congratulate all of you for being part of this KLU family. So I'd like to talk about my entrepreneurial journey since I left the college. So I went to the US in 2005 and pursued my master's in electrical engineering from Illinois Institute of Technology. And I worked with many MNCs like Motorola and Core EC, and after that I shifted to SAP And since then, I've been working with many software giants like Capgemini, IBM, Deloitte, Accenture, with various clientele. And I was in the US for about 7 years. And post that, I came back to India in 2012 and I started preparing for civil services. Then in 2013, I took up the IT profession back and I joined PricewaterhouseCoopers in Bombay and then to Bangalore. So I was with them for 3 years. And then in 2014, we started our journey with a company called Global Technology Solutions, which is an IT firm, which deals with product development and seed investment in technology and agro startups. Apart from that, we're also in the tourism sector with a company called Amaravati Boating Club, which is the leading water sports company in Andhra Pradesh and Odisha. So we are a tie-up with Andhra Pradesh Tourism Development Corporation and also Odisha Tourism Development Corporation. We are dealing with the tourism, professional sports, and also into regular tourism activities like recreation and inland waterways. Apart from that, we're also into the F&B space with our brand called Dosa King, which also had a stall at the KLU Festival recently. So having talked about my entrepreneurial journey, now I would like to talk about how KLU has actually molded us into leaders and made us as transformation thought process influences. So during the college days, we had a lot of interaction with our faculty, and some of the people that I would like to recollect are Mr. LSS Reddy, who taught us the subject along with, apart from being our honorable principal. And also we had people like Mr. K.M. Prasad, who was the HOD. We had other eminent faculty from all departments, and we are really lucky to have a very experienced staff who were actually able to guide us all the way to the end. And during our final year, we had a good number of companies come for campus recruitment, and also KLU really took care in terms of molding our career. Now, I would also like to talk about some of the opportunities that you have currently at KL, including the latest library, the green buildings that are available, the sports facilities, and also a lot of opportunities, including new departments that have been added, the international culture that has been recently added to KL. So all these are amazing experiences which I would like you to take care of. And also my advice to you is start building your skill set, not just the academics, but learn something on the skill sets, because coding right now is part of your basics. So learn to code, learn to do some basic coding also as part of your skill set. Apart from that, start learning additional languages. This will help you get placed in foreign universities and also in foreign MNCs much easier. So start building your skills, focus on your passion, don't get disheartened, stay courageous, stay motivated. With that, I would like to thank you and thank KL for this opportunity. Now, I also wish the Surabhi National Festival, the cultural fest which is going to be organized at KL University during the September 4th, 5th and 6th of this month. And our alumni is also going to be there on the 11th and 12th of the September. So I invite all my alumni friends to join us for this gathering, and I once again wish you all good luck. Thank you.
Hello all, hope you are all doing well during this time of pandemic. This is Prajwal Kotam Raju, co-founder and head of computer vision engineering at Automotus. I graduated from KLU in the year of 2016 with a bachelor's degree in ECE. So right after my intermediate, I was just a normal teenager with nothing special to talk about, apart from the fact that I was a little interested in the electronics field. But right after my bachelor's, I was a very confident individual who was able to forgo an offer from a big company like Huawei with a 7.5 lakh CTC, just in order to pursue my master's degree here in USA. So my days at KLU, taught me a lot of things to become what I am today. So let me share a few incidents which sort of helped me to become what I am today. In my first year, there was a professor, his name was Dr. V. Vasant Kumar. He used to teach C programming to us. And, I was a very big fan of him and wanted to get his attention or applaud somehow. So what I ended up doing is I executed 40 programs which were given to us as a part of homework assignment, which we were just supposed to write on paper, and showed it to him. So that day he said one thing. He said, this is the standard we expect an engineer to operate with. don't expect me to cheer for something which is already expected from you. That, you know, sort of made me a lot humble than what I was. So that also made me understand one fact, that the reward of a thing well done is to have done it. From that day, fast forward to 6 years later, today I get satisfaction from my work rather than what my work pays me off. So that was one of the important lessons. The other one was during my second year. This was from a professor, Dr. M. Venkat Narayana. So one day, a guy from an NGO, he came to our class and he wanted to raise some money. So we all ended up giving whatever we can and he left off. After he left, Dr. Venkat Narayana, he said a very beautiful sentence. If you love giving, then you should always try to become much more successful than the rest of the than the others. Because if you want to give to people, you have to be in a position where you can afford to give. So that is something which I will always hold close to my heart. So no matter how much big I become as a person, I would always want to grow more so that I can help the society a little more. In our final year, we ended up doing a few projects which at the time of their inception looked almost impossible. But our project supervisor, Dr. Pengi Satchanarayan sir, he used to have very high standards and he used to have strict deadlines for the deliverables. It almost used to feel like hell during that time. And we used to work late hours in order to, you know, meet the end goals. But by the end of the semester, we had a good prototype of a wheelchair, which automatically tracks the person in front of it and follows him. So that feeling was phenomenal. At the end, when you just look at the prototype and you have a project finished, which you initially thought was impossible, that feeling is phenomenal. So that day I understood one thing. No matter how hard it is to pursue a thing, if you really like the end objective, if you really feel that it is going to do some good to the society or to you, you have to pursue it no matter what. So at the end, we still remember that all of us, all of our team just sitting there and enjoying the prototype and playing with it. And we did not even care for what all the effort which went into it. Apart from all these, we have had tons of fun during our internship days at after our second year in KLU. And also we used to silently bunk a lot of classes and we used to go to Indo Stadium in order to play carom board or, you know, table tennis. Lots of the times it used to be carom board just because, you know, people wouldn't find us in there. You know, all these things were some things which we enjoyed during our days at KLU. These days would not come back, but I will always look back at them and, you know, admire the beautiful times which I have had there. So apart from that, speaking of the Surabhi event itself, hosting it on a virtual platform is a phenomenal idea. Artists are the people who are facing a lot of challenge during these tough times. So helping them and you know, promoting their art is our responsibility as a society. So I definitely, you know, applaud KLU for taking this initiative, and it was phenomenal to watch the fest during those 3 days. I hope you guys all take precautions and stay safe during this pandemic. And I hope you guys all will be saying, you know, terrific stories of how we survived this apocalypse to your future generations by exaggerating them. Thanks and all the best to you all.